All right, let's start with a big number. 3.2 million, how does that sound? So, you know, every year across the world, 3.2 million individuals die due to exposure to urban air pollution. So this is a pretty big problem. To add more to this problem, urban sprawl is, you know, pouring flame into this fire, because, you know, urban sprawl increases the distances between people's activity locations, which, you know, require them to travel more, and this leads to more emissions and more pollution levels. Moreover, we also found that lower socioeconomic status groups and minorities are bearing the brunt of this pollution problem. So, considering this problem, my research tries to understand how to better design cities, and more specifically, transportation infrastructure, so that we can reduce people's exposure to air pollution levels. So, I have created an integrated modeling framework which uses transportation and air pollution models to estimate people's exposure levels under different transportation and land use scenarios. So first, I use a transportation model to estimate when, where, and how people spend their time, as can be seen here. Following this, since I know where people are, I also know where their vehicle locations are. So I use that to estimate their emission values. Now, I input these emission values into a different air pollution model to understand how the pollution concentrations are distributed in the study region. Finally, I combine these two, the locations of the people with the locations of the concentrations to estimate their exposure levels. So, I performed a demographic analysis, and the study is focused on Tampa, and we found some exposure inequalities in Tampa. So specifically, we found that blacks and Hispanics have higher exposures compared to whites. We also found that people living in urban regions are exposed to more pollutions compared to people living in non-urban regions. So going forward, I would like to use this integrated modeling framework to estimate exposures under two different transportation and land use scenarios. So the first scenario is actually a business as usual case where automobile is a main mode of travel, and the city is also allowed to sprawl in the country. The second scenario is a transit-oriented scenario where the additional modes of travel are available, and the city also allows for a mixed use of growth. So this study has potential for understanding the relation between how this transportation infrastructure influences your exposure levels. So, in conclusion, this study has potential for understanding the relation between urban transportation design, air pollution exposures, and health.